Maryland State Board of Education just cleared the way for local school districts to lift mask mandates in the schools. WJZ is live, and Paul Gessler reports it comes with some lofty measures to meet. Paul.
Indeed, Denise, today's action extends the masking mandate statewide through the end of the school year. It would also allow those mandates to be lifted if local vaccination rates hit 80% or if transmission falls from where it is now.
Maryland public school students will keep masks on in schools for now.
We need to keep our students safe. We need to make sure that we can keep them in schools so that they can learn.
The state's school board approved new regulations Tuesday allowing local districts to lift the mask mandate if that county reaches a vaccination rate of 80%. If not, the mandate could be lifted if the transmission rate is low or moderate, as reported by the CDC.
So there are no districts that fit this criteria yet.
That's correct. And it gives them something to work towards.
Even though no Maryland county clears that 80% hurdle yet, the regulations allow for individual schools to lift the mandate if they reach the mark.
Masks are important because not everybody can be vaccinated. We need to improve the rates of vaccination.
I know we want to do what's right for the children, but at the same time, we're taking away the vote from the local boards who are talking to the parents who elect these board members.
As of Tuesday, more than 7,000 Maryland students are currently in quarantine. The state superintendent declined our interview request Tuesday, but says these new measures are all about keeping schools open.
Georgia, Tennessee, Texas, Florida, they've closed schools multiple times in the fall. Entire districts have closed for weeks.
The new regulations go next to a legislative committee for final approval.
If we can get control of the virus in our communities, nobody loves the masks. We would all love to be done with masks.
Again, today's action keeps that mask mandate in place now through the end of the school year, but gives incentives to communities to up their vaccination rates or slow the transmission to lift it at the local level. Those not vaccinated because of medical or religious exemptions may not be counted in that 80% threshold. For now, reporting live in Highlandtown, I'm Paul Gessler for WJZ.